How y'all doing? GBB here. Recently, there's been a lot of changes to the sniper skill leveling tasks. So I went ahead and updated this video in order to give you the most accurate information. So as before, we will cover what level it is you want to strive for, and then we'll go over how it is that you can get to that level. If you haven't already, maybe consider hitting that like and that sub. I come out with new videos every Friday, and I also stream over on Twitch. For anyone interested, there is a link in the video description. So first off, let's talk about levels. As you can see here, I have a couple skill levels at different areas. Big thing with these skill levels is you have to get the amount of experience needed for the level you're going to. So at first, you can see I'm level 5, and it requires 60 to get to level 6. Level 3 requires 40 to get to level 4, so on and so forth. This is a big thing when it comes to tasks that give you skill levels. For example, mentor task. You hand over 50,000 euros, and you get 3 skill levels in sniper. That's not so much experience, that's so many full levels. Now we dive a little deeper into this. You can see you have Tarkov Shooter Part 8, where you have to kill 3 PMCs in woods at 1 raid using bolt action, gives you 1 sniper level. Shooter Born in Heaven, where you have to kill 3 PMCs with a headshot from greater than 125 meters on shoreline, woods, customs, reserve, and lighthouse, gives you 1 sniper level. And then Mentor, which we just talked about, hand over 50,000 euros, gives you 3 sniper levels. These tasks you do not want to turn in until you've hit at least level 3 sniper, if you have aspirations of reaching Kappa. Reason being is once you start turning these in, you'll complete Wet Job Part 6, which is reach sniper level 7, which then will unlock Psycho Sniper, which is now reach sniper level 8. Now grinding all the way up to level 8 will be much more difficult than doing it this way. Both these tasks are Kappa required. Now that we've gone over a little bit on why it is you want to reach sniper level 3 on your own before turning in those 3 tasks, we can go over exactly how it is that you can go about reaching sniper level 3 in the most efficient manner. Now there's 2 ways to gain sniper level experience. That is hitting your shots and reloading your weapon. And with gaining experience, you ought to know too that there are modifiers. As you can see here, my assault rifles has a up blue arrow, and my sniper skill has no arrow. There is also a third indicator, which is a down red arrow. These arrows or lack of arrow indicate the bonuses or negatives that you're receiving in experience points. Now when it comes to hitting your shots, if you hit shots with an up arrow, you get 0.25 experience points in sniper. You hit shots without an arrow at all, you get approximately 0.2. and hits with a down red arrow will give you approximately 0.125 experience points. It doesn't matter where on their body you hit them, any sort of hit will give you this much experience points. As for reloading, it can get a little more tricky. So you have removable magazine reloading and you have top loading. When it comes to removable magazine, if you reload with an up arrow 4 times, you gain about 0.1 experience points. If you reload a magazine with no up arrow or down arrow, takes about 5 times to get 0.1, and if you have a down arrow, it takes approximately 8.5 per 1, so you'll get 1 at 8, then you'll get 1 at 9. Now if you thought that was a little confusing, so wait till we talk about top loading. Now if you have an up arrow or no arrow, you get approximately 0.1 experience points per bolt cycle reload. That is opening the bolt, putting one in, and closing it, like if you are just top loading a full Mosin. If you have a down arrow, you have to do that approximately 2 times for 0.1 experience points. Also, on top of that, if you have an empty gun, say you have a Mosin with no round in the chamber and none in, you get an additional 0.1 experience points for 5 rounds loaded, and that continues on with you. If you have no arrow, it takes about 10 rounds to get to 0.1. And if you have a down arrow, it takes about 20 rounds to get the extra one. Now, this sounds a little confusing, but I'll try to show you here in the video. You can see here, I have an empty M700 with a 10-round magazine. I just got into this raid. I have 31.1 points, so I'm gonna load in 10 rounds through the top of it. Now, since I have the up arrow, I should get 0.1 for opening the bolt, and then 0.1 for 5. So I should get 0.3 total, which as you can see, I do. Now I unloaded 5 from it just to show you that it works with just doing 5. So loading in 5 through the top, so I should get 0.1 for opening the bolt, and then an extra 0.1 for the 5 rounds loaded, which as you can see, it went from 31.4 to 31.6. And then just to kind of clarify this, open the bolt, put one in like people do with Mosins and whatnot, and you can see I went up 0.1. So I hope this helps kind of clarify on how exactly you can get to level 3 and why you want to get to level 3 to help, you know, min-max your sniper usage or experience. If any of this information in the video was new to you, again, greatly appreciate if you hit that like, hit that subscribe button, leave a comment down below if you have anything else you want to share in your experiences with leveling up sniper. But as always, I'll catch you guys next time.